this afternoon you will see the debate that we prepared for just a moment, just a while ago we prepared. So we are going to do a British parliamentary debate. So we already discussed about British parliamentary debate, but we have a modified British parliamentary debate because we have 5 members here and 5 members for the other side. So in British parliamentary debate, we have the first government or the proposition side or the affirmative side, and we have the second government or the opposition side. Now, the rules for this debate, each speaker will only have 5 to 7 minutes to state their points or ideas, and also they can have a maximum of 2 points of information each speaker. So that will be the rules for this event. Now, what will be our proposition? Our proposition is continuing professional development, a blessing or a burden. So now, I'm going to introduce to you, this is the affirmative side or the proposition side. Let's start with the Prime Minister. Next is the Deputy Prime Minister. We have second Deputy Prime Minister. We have government, a member of the government, and the last is the government pick. For the opposition side, we have also leader of the opposition, followed by the deputy leader of the opposition, followed again by second deputy leader, then we have member of the opposition, and the last is the opposition leader. So that will be the consisting of the debaters for this afternoon. Now to start our debate, let me have given you first a small background, a little background of what will be our discussion for this afternoon. Nowadays, as a future teachers, we are facing a great factors in which we are required to attend different seminars, seminar workshop, trainings, and others that will enhance our skills. So now, let me introduce to you the debating teams. Let's start the debate this afternoon with the affirmative side. Let's start the Prime Minister.
Documenting your development as professional. The document. You're learning and to develop and update your professional knowledge. Finally, CPD helps you with your career development or possible career. And as of today, I, as the Prime Minister, will be the first speaker of the government and will present to you an argument. Today, we, the government, strongly believe with the motion, continuing professional development, a blessing or a burden. Well, we, the affirmative team, strongly believe that continuing professional development is definitely a blessing and not a burden.
Points of information, please.
Why? Because according to Republic Act 10912, or being known as CPD law, based on the record of the Senate of the Republic of the Philippines, RA 10912, entitled as an act of mandating and strengthening the continuing professional development program for all regulated professions, creating continuing professional
information, please.
Okay, for your information, you may say that.
Is it really possible that this continuing professional development can really create a higher professional aspect to each individual behind from suffering from financial needs?
Well, thank you for your answer. Well, I may say and I may assure you that your question is possible. Why? I can depend on it. According to PRC, Action on CPD Implementation, they have concluded the steps towards affordability and accessibility. First, for the affordability, we have for professional availing CPD under the self-directed modality, the commission agreed to lower the processing fee at 500 pesos per applicant regardless of their numbers of programs. So, 500 per applicant. Further accessibility, we have noted the ICE 2078, the PRC, and the CPD councils have already accredited 28 government agencies which responded to the PRC's memorandum circular number 7, series of 2017. A similar call for the private sector employers to apply a CPD providing was made, resulting in accreditation of around 200 corporated and private employers with a total of 7,881 CPD programs from the 700 accredited CPD provides were approved. And that is the answer for your concern. To continue my speech, as the permitting side, I love to cite in article number 2, section number 10, CPD program and monitoring. Under this section, CPD has mandatory requirements in the renewal of professional license and accreditation system for the practice of profession. The CPD is hereby made a mandatory requirement in the renewal of PICs of all registered and licensed profession. It's under the regulation of Professional Regulatory Commissions or the PRC. On the other hand, the CPD law requires all licensed professionals in the Philippines to accumulate CPD credits from 15 to 45 units every 3 years. To conclude my speech, for the affirmative side, CPD is important because it ensures to continue to be the competent in your profession. It is an ongoing process to be competent in your lifestyle. It is a professional career where you can grow. If improving teaching quality opens the door to raising student achievement, then CPD holds the promise of a strong
CPD is a blessing and not a burden.
Let us hear from the leader of the opposition.
Good afternoon. I'm the leader of the opposition. The affirmative side had their details earlier that continuing professional development is generally used to mean as a physical holder. Our portfolio documenting the development as a professional, or it has the initial trainings. This process is used to mean a training or development plan, which I would argue that is not strictly accurate. The only problem with the affirmative side is that they fail to analyze the root causes or even the effect of this kind of process to every individual. The affirmative side is very weak because she raised and highlighted only the special trainings, workshops, action research, most probably the initial trainings, that they do not even understand or give importance to every individual's reasons and concerns in their everyday activities. There are numerous reasons and advantages that this continuing professional development will not suit to apply and it serves as a burden to our lives. Before I proceed to my speech, yes, please.
I disagree on your statement. Are you sure that it will not suit to apply and it is a burden to our lives?
Yes, I am very sure and I can prove it because first, it is a waste of time and effort. Please take note of that. This could be a barrier, especially to the teachers rather spend time with their family. Teacher weekends are supposed to be allotted with their family. If they undergo this kind of process, they would actually talk about what transpired during the week. And instead of focusing with their needs for the family, they would get in busy meetings with their relatives and friends, planning for the future and doing some projects with them. But what usually happens is waking up early to catch up with these classes, to reach out for that bus and the highways for 3 to 4 hours just to reach up that their classes. The question with that those entire situation is it worth sacrifices or it would take for granted? Second, they have a lot of clerical jobs. Meaning to say clerical jobs, they are most often in office hours, accounting, religious, bookkeeping in a school or in every institution. Instead of attending those sessions and trainings and workshops, they would prefer to focus on what they're doing in current work. Third, lack of opportunity. Most probably, for example, teachers are not given the opportunities to attend seminars given by the DepEd. And it is always based on their rules and responsibilities for that. And fourth, most individuals are already in the field for decades, that they have already mastered their crafts and they are under expertise. And if it is still implementing, it will bring struggles and burden to our lives. And last, it is expensive and not realistic. The seminars and trainings under the continuing professional development are costly and are not accessible to busy professionals. I am here according to Manila Times. An example is to other profession is a ward nurse. That finally, after working 6 years for the National Kidney and Transplant Institute, a 28 years old Maria Arlen Cristina Cargensha became a regular employee. This development comes with a salary raise, so her basic pay now is at 20,000 pesos. She waited for 6 years to get this salary increase. It's not much, but as a regular employee, Cargensha still has it better than most of her colleagues or previous classmates as well, who are still working and contractual employees. And of course, unlike her, a 29-year-old Victor Romero, a nurse from the same ward or hospital, has been working for more than 4 years, but he is a contractual employee. In a good month, he earned 40,000 pesos, and also his wife is working with that same hospital for much longer years, but also a contractual employee earning just as much. Both of them who have just recently started raising their own family, but now they have to find a way to budget their needs. Two small salary have tighter as continuing professional development act come in the full swing, they started to struggle in a way that all of them and other professionals to attend those centers and trainings that don't always come cheap or make it in the lower cost. Based on that situation, we can all relate and all regard to spend our money even if we are tightly in financial difficulties. The cost of seminars and trainings are the primary concerns. Seminars from private CPD providers can cost them at least 1,000 pesos per month per session, and they will have to join several to get required 45 minutes. There are also cheaper alternatives, but some institutions who have these trainings at just 500 to 650 per session, but this doesn't happen on a regular basis. Based from that scenario, we can say that cheaper alternatives in a lower cost for training, but now as we can see, it's really a heartbreaking. Furthermore, this continuing professional development acts dreams of making Filipino professionals globally competitive, but it would have helped if they consulted and listened to those who have affected first. It's not just about points. After all, it's about money, time, and effort.
Then proceed to the Deputy Prime Minister.
Through professional able to go back to the classroom and make changes to their lecture styles and curricula to better suit the needs of their students.
Point of information, please.
Yes, please.
Are you sure in the future, learning new strategies, it will easily adapt by the students?
Yes! Because the generation today is very different from before. They are very flexible to adopt new things, new information, and they easily acquire it. For example, when your child exposes it to the new environment with a good environment, for sure, you expect that your child may get that kind of attitude or good feedback from that kind of environment.
Become more
influence, coach, and mentor others. These are several ways to encourage CPD. One of the most effective and cost-efficient ways to help teachers refresh their knowledge and pedagogical practice is to encourage exchange information and ideas between the teachers and their own school.
Points of information, please.
Completing CPD helps build confidence and credibility. It allows us to showcase achievements and equips with tools to cope positively with change.
Proceed to the second deputy leader of opposition.
Good afternoon. I am the leader of the deputy leader of opposition. So at least 43,000 Filipino professionals have signed an online petition to be revising and requirements for renewing their license under the Continuing Professional Development or CPD Act, which took effect as last March. Ruben Lapadia, a 24 years old, he showed up creating the petition of changing board because he found out the operational guidelines of the CPD Act, Republic Act number 10912, professional. He said this professional will not be burdened by the costly and time consuming seminar and training.
For some information, please.
Yes.
Yes, it is costly and consuming. What do you think is the return of investment for the teachers?
Yes. Training and seminars are very important for the teacher. But, I said earlier, it's a time consuming and to gain the units of the CPD. To continue my speech. A lot of people think that our bank accounts are overflowing just because we're teacher. But not that the case. I'm from one who was a victim of the transactionalization upon the resignation, higher paying job were difficult even after gaining work experience. He said the law was counterproductive. As being CPG seminar, a specialization, leaving professional with no choice but to take the CPD training for shape of points.
Let's hear it from the member of the government.
Good afternoon. I'm a member of the government. According to the online accredited researches and legitimate blog in the internet, that CPD is very helpful in the gaining of new knowledge and skills, especially in the field of teaching. Even if it is costly and consuming, with the time in taking up the CPD, but the learning and skills that gain in CPD are so important to keep the teacher skills intact and up to date. CPD will keep it energized the sparking creativity and passion into the teaching career, keeping the teacher curriculum in our by keeping the teacher in touch with the techniques and theories that greatly needed in the new curriculum in our country. The teacher that experiences the CPD in a few years can now explore more advances in the field of teaching. In this program, the teachers become more competitive and productive in the teaching industry and an aid for the farmer promotion of the teachers.
What's the information?
Yes, please. Thank you. Yes, in the recent researches of Barclay Institute, the employees and teachers that already gained accept CPD programs in their degree, increase their capability and sense of passion in teaching. They become more responsible and energetic to their workplace. Improvements in practice of the new techniques were observed in the teachers. They are likely to be competitive and more standardized in the methods of teaching. And CPD is one of the basic requirements in the global market, especially in global competition, to the career in teaching. As I continue, if we talk about global career competition, the teachers take up CPD can employ easily and suit to the best position in a school or company. It is not a barrier in the professional teacher, but an advanced education with a better work and teaching the students in the classroom and also for the future.
Let's hear it from the member of the opposition.
So, education doesn't end
Manushar. And the Commission of Education is also considering those issues. And attending programs, seminars, workshops doesn't mean that they will stop supporting their families, because it is like what I said, it is not done in workshop. It is not done every day, every month, or every day or every month. It is done, it is planned and done in every month, not literally every day. It is done with the interval of months. It doesn't mean that we have programs in this month and the other months we have. No, it's not like that. So they still have fun, or they still have, they can support their family. And they have salary, so if they can save from their salary every month. And then professional development gives them opportunity to step out of their routine. They get to be the student in need of the teacher. This gives educators engaged because they feel like they are receiving professional help, they need to be better teachers. After all, professional development nurtures the talents of teachers who apprise to take an educational leadership position, and teachers must learn from other experienced leaders to become effective future leaders themselves. And implementing professional education development has benefit for both teachers and students. Most importantly, it helps teachers become better educators and develop into competent future school administrators. So CPD is not a burden, it's a blessing.
For the last speaker, for the member of the opposition, and then the government wing, let us hear from the speaker. For the opposition, we have 5 minutes.
To summarize on our team, for what we have. CPD is a burden. Why? Because it is time consuming, it costs so much, and effort is wasted. Well, attending special trainings can cost a lot to the part of a teacher. Well, a teacher's life, personal life can be cost. Can be changed for the time they have to their family, the special training or not. The thing that teacher already have a low salary in our country. We are not that much of important when it comes to salary. We have low salary. So if we give it, if we put it to CPD, special trainings and whatnot. What's more for their family, of course. Sure, education is never ending process, but is it really, is CPD really that essential for the teacher's personal life to be caught up to? We are teachers, we have our own lives, we have on our lives to focus on. According to our leader of opposition, CPD is not that accurate. Their problem is they fail to analyze their new process. They only highlight the special training and workshops. They're not suited to apply. Waste of time and effort. Teachers are overworked instead of focusing on their family, lack of opportunity. Most of the individuals are already under expertise. It's disappointing for their part if another program is added. Also, teachers don't get young. old, we don't have that much of time. Life is short. We also have financial difficulties. According to our deputy leader, it is exhausting. Part of our member of opposition, it is teacher exhaustion. I mean, the paradox of CPD, teacher exhaustion, workload, early night session. To summarize it, the CPD is vicious circular. School CPD is not effective because teacher exhaustion and workload mean that the material power does not stick and is not actively embedded in practice. Yet teacher exhaustion and workload are exactly why an effective training program is so crucial. If done well, such a program provides teacher in the direction, resources and support to make changes that they would not have the time to make on their own. Because just like what I said from a while ago, teachers do not get younger. They also get older. They're not immortal. We can spend too much time on other. We have our own selves too. We have our own family to focus on and our own family to take care of.
Okay, thank you two sides, the affirmative and the opposition side. Now, we all know that debate is not just about who is right, right? But it is about how you defend your proposition. Now, let's declare this debate as a tie. Because both teams defend their position, their side. Both teams cite facts, cite their opinions, cite articles, cite researches based on their researches their own and based on their own knowledge. Now, let's end their debate with a big round of applause. Thank you. Members of the government. Let's start with the affirmative side. Prime Minister, we have Lani Iba. Deputy Prime Minister, Ms. Julian Kapan. Deputy Prime Minister, Maymay Aquilet. We have the member of the government, Joel Manapo. And the last is the government team, Angelica. For the member of the opposition side, we have the leader of the opposition, Ms. Rachel Guevara. We have also the deputy leader of the opposition, Karen Jesuhales. We have the second deputy leader, Mr. Mark Oliver. Member of the opposition, Ruth Beldalima. For last but not least, the opposition whip, Alicia Delgado.